tool belts, kids, and join me on this old plank. I'm your host, Woodworking Willie. Today we'll be building a large wooden badger, which makes an excellent gift for a loved one, yes?
Master Richie, any luck deciding what you'll be getting your father for his birthday tomorrow?
Gosh, no, Cadbury. What do I do? I don't want to buy him a gift. I'd rather make him something with my own hands. It'll be more special that way.
Well, if I may make a suggestion, sir.
Hey, this is a great idea, Cadbury. Dad loves chocolate. I bet I could make him the best tasting chocolate bar ever.
So, you want to make your father a chocolate bar, eh?
Not just any old chocolate bar, Chef Pierre. I want to make the world's greatest chocolate bar ever.
Ah, in order to make the world's greatest chocolate bar, you must use the world's greatest chocolate. And according to my recipe for the world's greatest chocolate bar, there's only one place in the whole world where you can find the world's greatest chocolate. But none has ever braved the perils of the jungle to find it.
Not until now. Lost Village, here we come! Wow, we found it! This is gonna be easier than I thought. Excuse me, sir. I'm Richie Rich, and this is Cadbury. We'd like to buy some of your chocolate.
Oongala hula hula!
Oh, no. He doesn't speak English.
Fear not, Master Richie. I happen to speak a little Marubi.
Yaga Ganda! Yamahala Wandu!
Oh, Mawo Gato Gato!
I say there, that's a good one, old chap.
What do you say, Cadbury?
Well, quite simply, sir. His chocolate is not for sale. However, the native chief is willing to make a trade for a pound of it.
What does he want us to trade him for it?
An Abe Lincoln lunchbox, sir. He needs it to complete his collection.
Abdullah, ugh! Honest Abe!
What shall I tell him, Master Richie?
Tell him it's a deal!
But, sir, how do you propose to locate an Abe Lincoln lunchbox?
By surfing the net, of course.
Cowabunga, dude! Whoa! That was a gnarly wave, dude! Check it out! Here's a congressman who owns an Abe Lincoln lunchbox!
Bravo, Master Richie!
Ask him, hang a left. We're heading for Washington!
Right, I shall...
So, gentlemen, let's put it to a vote.
Nay.
Yay.
Yay.
Nay.
Yeah.
Nay.
Excuse me, Congressman. Nay. I saw on the internet that you own an Abe Lincoln lunchbox. Is that right, sir?
Heck yeah. I carry my fried chicken and pork rinds in it every darn day. Isn't she pretty?
Yes, sir. In fact, it's so pretty that I'd love to trade you for it.
Shoot. There's only one thing in this whole world I'd trade my honest Abe for.
What, sir? Name it.
An autographed... Oh, shoot. Hold on.
Nay!
Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. I'll trade you this here lunchbox for one of those autographed pictures of my favorite movie star, Miss Taylor Todd.
Oh, well, I'm afraid I really don't see how we could possibly...
We got a deal. Hollywood, here we come.
This endeavor's growing more complicated by the moment, sir.
Yeah, but Dad's worth it. Besides, Cadbury, as soon as we get Miss Todd's autograph, we're home free.
No way you're getting Miss Todd's autograph. Not gonna happen, no can do in a word. Uh-uh.
Mr. Brimstein, sir.
Call me Marty.
Crunch, Dudley. Crunch, Dudley.
Mr. Marty, sir, we'd be willing to trade you something for Miss Todd's autograph.
Oh, dear me, here we go again.
Oh, don't make me laugh while I'm working my abs. You want to trade with me? You want to trade with me? Forget it, kid. Look, I have caviar right here in my desk drawer. Groovy, huh? Looky here. I have an unlisted home phone number. So private, so secret, I don't even know the number. Groovy, huh?
Groovy.
Groovy, indeed.
So forget about trying to make a trade, because there's nothing you have that I could possibly want. A cat's eye. Groovy. You didn't get this from me.
We did it, Cadbury.
Groovy. I mean, splendid.
Now, all we have to do is fly back to Washington and trade this for the Abe Lincoln lunchbox, and then fly back to South America and trade that for the chocolate, and then fly back home to bake my dad's birthday present. Hey, kid, what's the matter?
All I wanted in the world was to get in the studio and meet Taylor Todd and get her autograph. But the guard said, get a life. Now I'll never get it.
Yes, you will.
Zowie! Gee, thanks. You're the nicest kid in the whole world.
Cadbury, you're getting rather misty-eyed.
Well, you may have just lost any hope of getting your father's birthday present, but I know he would be extremely proud of you, Master Ritchie.
And so am I.
It's...
Ah.
That was a very generous thing you did, young man. And such generosity should be rewarded. Will this do?
Thanks! Gotta go!
Come to Papa.
Thanks. Gotta go.
Umdullah, honest Abe.
Thanks. Gotta go.
Sacre bleu! I don't believe it. You found it.
Happy birthday, Dad.
Why, thank you, son.
Happy birthday, dear. I love you, Dad.
Mom. Oh. I don't believe I've ever tasted chocolate this good. And you even made it yourself?
Yep, with a little help from Cadbury.
Gosh, I hope you two didn't go to too much trouble.
Oh, no, Dad. It was no trouble at all. Right, Cadbury?
Absolutely right, son.
Rich has got the Midas touch and the heart of solid gold. Richie never will forget his pals. Friendship can't be undersold. Just a little kiss from Gloria. Richie starts to blush and twitch.
Dot and Pee-wee Freckles Tiny too. You know they love Richie Rich.
Chef Pierre Cuisine Extraordinaire.
Bumbler Cadbury's the best.
Maid Irona, she has nerves of steel.
Maid Imani, you're the best.
Chauffeur Bascom is a highway king.
Reggie is a little snitch.
Everybody's ready for some fun.
Come on, let's join Richie Rich.
Come on, come all to the Bigley Top Circus.
No one in our family has ever been to the circus.
Who'll be the first to buy a ticket?
I'll take 4 dozen tickets for my friends and me, please.
That's the spirit.
Now your whole family can go.
Wow. Thanks, Richie. Pee-wee said to say thank you, too.
Hey, you can't do that. I just bought 48 tickets to the circus.
I'm afraid I can't, son. I'm Bigley Top, and I own this outfit. My circus performers have been waiting for peanuts.
Well, at least they have pride in their work.
No, I mean real peanuts. Even the elephants are sick of eating them. And if I don't sell my circus to the highest bidder, they're all gonna walk out on me.
Oh, my friends were so much looking forward to seeing it. How much are you selling it for?
That's nice, son. But you better run home to your mama and...
I hope this is enough.
Holy flying puppies! Consider yourself the proud owner of the Bigley Top Circus, boy.
Excuse me. Pardon me.
Oh, me. Oh, my.
Mr. Top, what's wrong?
It's too late. I can't sell you the circus. All my performers have deserted. We'll have to give everyone their money back, and you'll have to turn away all your friends.
My friends, I've got a plan. It's up to us to see that the show goes on.
I could be a bareback rider, Richie. At least on a slow-moving mule.
Good. We'll use one of my prize mules from the Rich Family Farm.
We could be a team, Gloria.
Oh, hello, Maida.
You can ride on my shoulders. That is, if you think you can balance.
Well, of course I can. But I don't think I really want...
Look, it's important that we all work together as a team.
Don't you want to be a member of the team, Gloria?
Oh, all right.
I'll do anything you say, Richie, but first I must tell you about my new invention.
We're short on time right now, Professor. Can it wait?
Well, just watch this.
Why, Professor Keenbean, I didn't know I was attracted to you.
Oh, it's not my devilish charm this time, Irona. It's this space-age magnet. You can program it to attract only what you want.
That gives me a great idea. There's Reggie. Reggie, what do you want to be in my circus?
The star, of course.
Well, you could be the lion tamer.
Huh, taming ferocious beasts? Not bad.
Here's our lion now.
Woo-hoo! Oh, sorry, man. I don't work with puny animals.
Aw, don't listen to him, Dollar. You're the king of beasts.
Richie, I almost forgot to tell you. You must be very careful about the tent. If the ropes are not kept very tight, the whole tent could collapse.
See you later, pal. I'm gonna find a seat inside. This should be lots of fun. Like watching a car crash.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Richie Rich Circus! May I direct your attention to the amazing poise and composure of the incredible Cadbury, the butler of the high wire!
One lump or two?
And now please direct your attention to ring number one. This miracle of modern technology, a metallic maiden named Irona, will be shot out of a large caliber cannon and land feet first in ring number three.
Oh, I hate seeing my cousin Richie get ahead. That applause should be for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Rich Circus Clowns! Thank you! And now, that gourmet juggler, our own Chef Pierre!
When I give you the cue, you get on my shoulders. Do you think you can manage that?
Yes, of course I can. And now, the magnificent bareback stylings of the always lovely Gloria Glad and Maida Money. He would give you top billing.
Wanted to see Richie's downfall.
Rich, Rich, Rich!
What is it, boy? Oh no! The tent's going to collapse! I hope this works! Ladies and gentlemen, I will now personally perform for you an astounding feat of daring! Professor Keenbean, throw me the magnet! Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was our favorite clown, Reginald Van Dough. Reggie, take a bow.
Oh, I just love the circus.
Can we go again, Mom?
Clown Reggie was so funny.
The Rich
Witch Circus will dazzle you like nothing you've ever seen before.
Richie, you've given me some wonderful ideas for new acts. My performance is so inspired. I would like to buy back my circus. And I also want to reward all your wonderful friends for saving my circus. I tell you what I'm going to do.
What are you going to do with your lifetime pass to the circus, Pee-wee?
What did he say, Freckles?
Live a long time, of course.
Leave alone!
Thank you. They say no man has ever escaped from the Richfield Rock. They say breaking out of this joint just can't be done. They say lots of men have tried, but none have ever succeeded. But I say different, because tonight, I am breaking out. And then my first order of business will be to get revenge on that goody, goody rich family for sending me to jail.
Come on, Dollar. You ready to play fetch, boy?
Rich! Rich, rich!
Go get it, Dollar. Go fetch!
Rich!
Good catch, Dollar.
I say, Master Richie, have you noticed the time?
No. I better check my watch that Professor Keenbean made for me.
The time is 10:15 and 36.2 seconds.
Gosh, Cadbury, it's almost time for our Rippy and Crashman superhero show at the Richville Hospital. The kids there are counting on us to cheer them up. We better get into our costumes.
I'm way ahead of you, sir.
Hey, we have to go now, Dollar. Sorry, Dollar, but there must be something else you like as much as playing fetch.
Rich! Rich!
Fifi!
Mmm! Breakfast!
Hey, yo! That's my truck! Hey, stop!
Figure out a way to make that goody-goody rich family pay for sending me up the river. Well, as I live and breathe, I'll nab that mutt and hold him for ransom. That way, I'll get sweet revenge. And I'll get stinking rich.
Crashman?
Right behind you, Master Richie. I mean, Rippy.
We're getting a call on the Rippy-mobile's one-cylinder, two-way, 3D transistorized videophonic receiver.
Attention, you goody-goody riches. As you can see, I have dog-napped your dog.
It's the Onion.
And look! The malodorous malcontent has made off with Dollar.
Listen up. If you ever want to see him again, you'll hand over 39.5 million bucks. That's $1 million for each dollar sign on your dog's coat.
Then what's the extra half million for?
That's for the sense sign on the dog's belly.
Oh, really?
Bring the ransom money to the old deserted onion farm.
If I may say so, sir, the Onion is an offensive, odious oaf. I do beg your pardon, sir. Shall we burn some rubber?
Stop your yapping! Keep it up and I'll breathe on you! Works every time.
Let's just hope my plan works.
Well, well, look who's here. The billionaire brat and his busybody butler. And in superhero costumes.
That's right, Onion. It's for our show we're putting on for the kids at the hospital.
Goody goodies. Hand over my dough. Then you get your dog back.
Okay, Onion. If you want it, then go get it. Go fetch. Go fetch, boy.
Hey, what the? Wait, whoa.
Go get it.
Righto. Oh, chickadee-boo. Go, Dollar, go.
Good boy, Dollar.
You tricked me.
Yep, we sure did.
Unquestionably.
Well, I don't give up easily. I'll get my revenge yet, Richie Rich.
Let's go, Crash Man.
Indeed, Rippy.
Hey, 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 watch it!
Try you!
Move aside!
ripe for your plan, Master Richie Bravo.
The time is 10:32 and 51.3 seconds.
We have 3 minutes before our Rippy and Crashman show starts. There's still time to catch him.
Splendid. Shall we make tracks?
Oh, look, a doggy.
Hi, you cute little boy.
Yuck!
Oh, what a stench.
Ew!
Where is everyone?
Watch.
The onion's been this way, all right.
Here, I'll see. Oh, these poor tots.
Luckily, I have a can of Professor Keenbean stink neutralizer.
A full can, one would hope.
What?
Huh?
Oh, a cute dog and a stinky man!
What's going on here?
You have your dog back, so now I'm the rightful owner of this bag. I've been doomed!
Your reign of terror is over, Onion.
Ha! You two are no match for me.
Fire, Crash Man!
As you wish, Rippy. Thank you, you're too kind.
And now, it's tea time.
Richie Rich has got the Midas touch. And the heart of solid gold. Richie never will forget his pals. Friendship can't be undersold. Just a little kiss from Gloria. Richie starts to blush and twitch.
Dollar B, we freckles tiny too. You know they love Richie Rich.
Chef Pierre, cuisine extraordinaire.
Butler Cadbury's the best.
Maid Irona, she has nerves of steel.
Maid Imani of the past.
Chauffeur Bascom is a highway king.
Reggie is a little snitch.
Everybody's ready for some fun.
Come on, let's join Richie Rich.
When you invited me to see your dad's gold mine, I figured we'd both be wearing grunge.
But we are. See how faded the silk tie is?
Who are they?
Thomas and Alva Rich. They were inventors back in the 1800s. Dad once said they were ahead of their time.
Most folks keep a photo album.
Come on, we're late.
Come along, kids. Richie, I'm glad to see you wore your old clothes. The gold mine, Bascom. Which one, sir? Number 1313. The one by the Cactus Gulch. Ah, yes. The old ghost town.
Ghost town?
Oh, merely a legend, son. Of course it is, sir. Merely a legend.
Dad, do you mind if Gloria and I go explore a bit?
Fine, but be careful, son. This mine is old and dangerous.
Yeah, and haunted.
Oh, this place is creepy. I love it.
This is a ghost town. Those ghosts look pretty lifelike.
Extra, read all about it Reggie the Kid escapes from jail.
Freckles?
Yes, sir, that's what they call him. Extra, extra, read all about it.
Richie, look at the date. 1896. But Freckles is here. And that's Reggie.
You mean Reggie the Kid. He's one mean, greedy varmint.
Some things never change.
Them rich brothers must be at it again.
Did you say rich brothers?
Yeah, Thomas and Alva. Poor devils, their inventions never work.
Step right up, folks. Bumpy ride, hurting your hide? Try our sore-free saddle. A cushy for your tushy.
Guess it still has some bugs in it.
You know what they say, Mr. Rich? If at first you don't succeed...
Quit! After so many failures, it should be our motto.
You can't quit. You're just ahead of your time.
Do we know you kids?
Well, I'm sort of a distant cousin. Are these more of your inventions?
Yep, and we can't sell any of them.
Wow, I love toy whistles.
It's not a toy, it's...
a buffalo whistle. Probably doesn't work any better than the saddle.
Doesn't matter. We're out of money to finance new inventions anyway.
Oh, well, but you can't give up.
You fellas need an investor.
Will this help?
How did you say we were related?
I'll take that. He's taking the exercise bike.
Don't worry, we'll get him.
Exercise bike?
Why didn't we think of that?
Reggie the Kid has struck again! He's getting away!
Gloria, are you all right? Terrific. Good, because this just gave me an idea.
Richie has a plan. We need this saddle.
But it doesn't work.
That's what we're counting on.
Those kids will never catch me.
The future of the Rich family is counting on you. No pressure.
Dang, he's getting away.
Keep your eyes on the saddle.
Oh, yeah, this saddle feels mighty cushy on my tushy.
Where'd you get that darn anti-horse thieving device?
At the Rich Invention Emporium.
Well, I'll take 10 of them. As for you, you're heading for a big time out.
Reggie the Kid caught by amazing saddle. Rich brothers invent miracle anti-theft device.
Hold that pose, guys.
Cheese!
It's been fun, cousins. Keep up the good work, and remember what I told you.
Plastics! Bye, Richie.
Bye, Gloria.
Master Richie, you're filthy. Good thing you wore grunge.
You'll never believe it, Cadbury. We fell into a time tunnel and ended up in the Old West with Thomas and Alva Rich, who invented the ejector saddle and caught Reggie the Kid.
Such an imagination. He gets it from my side.
Yes, quite.
But it's true, Mr. Rich. It was a rousing adventure.
And the haunted mine was right over... there. It felt so real.